Hi, I'm Thomas, and I'm a sex researcher. There are a ton of different ways you can protect yourself from STIs and HIV, but what's been called the most promising biomedical HIV prevention technique is probably one you're not even aware of, and something you might want to use. This is pre-exposure prophylaxis, PrEP. It's a blue pill that, when taken daily by individuals who are HIV negative, has been shown to be up to 99% effective in the prevention of acquiring HIV. In 2012, PrEP was approved by the United States Food and Drug Administration after having gone through various clinical trials to prove it's both safe and effective. Trials included a ton of different populations: men who have sex with men, heterosexuals, transgender individuals, and even injection drug users. PrEP works by basically making a shield around your immune system T cells, which blocks the HIV virus from entering the cells and replicating. Thus, the virus dies and isn't able to infect your body. This is a huge step forward for HIV prevention and has the potential to stop all new transmissions globally. But if you've never heard of PrEP and you're wondering why, well, it's controversial. Big surprise, something about sex is controversial. There are a lot of people that think that by promoting PrEP, they're promoting engagement in sex without condoms. And there is some research that shows that condom use does change for some people when they begin taking PrEP. But there's also research showing that condom use doesn't change, and that people who were inconsistent condom users before going on PrEP, well, they continue to be inconsistent condom users while on PrEP. There's also some research that has shown PrEP may be linked to more bacterial STI diagnoses, presumed to be from people not using condoms consistently while on PrEP. But being on PrEP also means you're required to get tested for STIs every 6 months, which means more frequent diagnosing. And honestly, how many of you watching this can say that you get tested for HIV every 3 months and STIs every 6? Probably not very many of you. And if we all did, then of course diagnoses would be higher. It's entirely possible to have an STI and have zero symptoms. So if you haven't been tested, now might be a good time. Aside from all the controversy, none of it changes the fact that PrEP works at preventing HIV. And currently there are over 120,000 prescribers in the US benefiting. But estimations run in the millions for individuals who would meet CDC criteria for uptake, which means a lot of people aren't taking it that maybe should be. In 2014, the Center for Disease Control and Prevention recommended PrEP to anyone who is at substantial risk for HIV. But what does that mean? Substantial risk? Well, the CDC defined it as anyone who engages in sex with a partner who has HIV, if you're someone who has had a recent bacterial STI, a high number of sex partners, a history of inconsistent condom use, if you're a commercial sex worker, and for people who share needles for drug injections. If you meet any of these, you might be a good candidate. I was a contributing author to research published in the Journal of Acquired Immune Deficiency Syndrome that examined people and their views on PrEP, and we uncovered some alarming results. Of the 995 men in our sample, 647 met CDC criteria to begin taking PrEP, but more than 50% of those were either unwilling or didn't view themselves as someone who should be on PrEP. What that shows us is that there are a lot of people at risk for HIV that don't even view themselves as someone who's at risk, and that's a problem. If you'd like more information about PrEP, go to the CDC link below. If you think you might want to talk to a doctor about PrEP, go to preplocator.org. Once you're there, all you have to do is put in your zip code and it'll show you places near you where you can get PrEP. This medication can be expensive without insurance, but there are a ton of different options to pay for PrEP, including even a cost assistance program through the company that produces PrEP. If PrEP is something you're considering, talk to your healthcare provider about your risk, because keeping yourself as healthy as possible is the bottom line. I've published a good amount of research on PrEP, and you can find them all on my website. But I also plan to talk more about it here. In fact, I've got an episode coming up about PrEP use in porn. Subscribe so you don't miss out. You can also follow me on Instagram and Twitter to stay up to date on more content that's coming your way. A few of you have already sent me messages asking me to cover a specific topic, and I'm totally open to suggestions. I'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching. I've got a lot of content in production and I don't want you to miss out. So go ahead and click that subscribe button. In the meantime, check out one of these other videos. And don't forget to send me your questions about sex, thomastalksabout@gmail.com.